So brothers, any questions about the supplement? Now, what do, let me go to it. Who is Nutrabolix? Nutrabolix is a supplement company from Canada. Well, basically, first company in the world to actually sell halal supplements. Now, we just got into Pakistan, Dubai, Doha, Qatar, and the Middle East, 30 countries, just selling that product. Now, Trinidad was easy to get into, right? So, you know, Trinidad. In Pakistan, now, the actual criteria to get into the country is not just a FDA approval. It's like how I have to go through the whole certification. We've got a Shiraz here to get all that in certification, but this company has a code on the bag that had a QR scanner. So you scan the bag, and the bag takes you straight back to the QAA and the COA and the COH. Certificate of health and certificate of origin. So the product now is what? It's weight loss products, and products that help you to gain lean muscle mass. Now the products are like, what is protein? Protein basically is a building block. Different types of branched-chain amino acids. It will help you to gain muscle mass. Now we might not consume the amount of protein from food. That is why supplements help us, because it has more nutrients. Let me give you an example. Now, being in the bodybuilding industry, taking a supplement is not going to get you big and muscular like me. All right? It will help you to sustain and to get the nutritional fat that the body needs daily. So if you're going to the gym like these ladies, and you want to lose weight, and you're basically going to the gym, but you're not seeing any change. You know, see, you burn it, it takes 3,500 calories to lose 1 pound. You have to burn 3,500 calories to lose 1 pound. The human body only burns, a man burns 2,000 calories, and a female burns 1,600 calories a day. So it's like when you're eating it, basically, and you're eating KFC, Royal Castle, pizza, you're not checking calories. Calories are in Chinese food, everything. Now, bear in mind, you might have a different body structure that may allow you to stay skinny and lean and ectomorphic, like yourself. But then him now, he's endomorphic. The fellow next year, endomorphic. So we have no mesomorphic. The only mesomorphic is me. And he's the most muscular person in the room. But that's based on training, lifestyle change, and my diet. And my competitive diet being a professional athlete. Right? So the supplement basically being halal and being vegan, so it's plant-based extracts. It's safe to take if you're worried about that. So the credibility is there in the company. If you want to search online on Nutrabolix.com. We just came back from Vancouver in December, and we launched that in our stores. For the past 2 months, we sold out literally half product have gone, just for being halal. So we close to my ashram, Masjid Saeed on Charlie Village. So a lot of people come and we give them the help they need. Now, using a supplement is one thing, but we have to look at nutrition. Nutrition have to follow it. So there's always a healthier choice. Right? Then we have training has to follow it. So we have to have a holistic approach. Now bear in mind, I have a lot of suppliers all over the world that supply supplements. Regardless in a Muslim country, I don't think that Muslim women or Muslim men should, not because we don't dress or we don't carry about ourselves like them, that don't mean that we can't keep ourselves looking good, feeling healthy, and going to the gym and lifting up some iron and seeing our goal and obtaining a goal. We get one. High cholesterol will fix with what? If you're pre-diabetic, it will fix with what? Stress will fix with what? Any coronary risk factor for heart disease will fix through exercise. We had a topic this morning about women with polycystic ovaries. Women can't get pregnant due to eating poorly, they're putting on too much weight from high glycemic index sugars, they have PCOS or hypoactive thyroidism. So bear in mind, with a woman, she can't get pregnant because she has PCOS. But once she loses weight, she can get pregnant. Basically, that's how it works. Secondly, if you have a hypoactive thyroid, which is a slow-acting thyroid, that means the body cannot burn calories efficiently. So I have a hyperactive thyroid, hence the reason you will always be lean. But it also have a lot more complications. So, you know, at the end of the day, it's all about what you might take a supplement, it might work differently for you. This brother might take it, it might work differently for him. We are tolerant to different stimulants in those products. So you're not tolerant to caffeine. Let's just say you drink one cup of coffee a day. Now that supplement, you have up to 600 grams of caffeine. That is 4 cups of coffee in one scoop. What that will do you? So at the same time, you'll get like a junkie, you'll be crazy, you'll become like anxious. You can go into a panic attack. At the same time now, we have to advise you that, okay, that is not the best thing for you. So that is why we are here. So any questions you might have around the supplement, plus we are also here to advise you, we are going to put our workouts in the gym, like blow up workout, like chest day, back day, biceps and triceps day, shoulders, quadriceps and hamstrings. So now, when you come in the gym, you don't have to worry about, what am I going to do today, boy? You might say chest and biceps. And I will try to keep it layman terms, because I don't want to say brachialis and bicep brachial. I'll be like, what are we talking about? I'll try to talk layman terms. You work your leg today. You will see the exercises for quadriceps, you'll see the exercise for hamstring. I will tell you on the duration of the rest period, and I can also put up healthy diet plans for you all if you have any website. I can post up some healthy plans that the woman could benefit from eating properly and living a healthy lifestyle. So like, simply I get up in the morning, fasting coming. Even April month, right? That mass fusion there is made with sweet potato flour, quinoa flour, and maxime starch. 28 grams of protein per scoop with 70 grams of carbs. You can start your fast with that every morning with a bowl of oats. You mix the oats with the protein. And you'll be sustained longer than if you eat bread and cheese. I'm just telling you. So people who have put on muscle throughout the year, who are trying to get abs and who are trying to put on lean muscle mass, who have a belly, and at that period of time they're looking to lose weight, they will continue, they will, in Ramadan, you hold on to fat. You know that, right? You don't lose weight in Ramadan, you lose muscle mass. Because you're starving, so the body holds on to fat for survival. So when you break fast, your body will consume it and you basically utilize it and store it as fat. What I'm saying, I don't want you to eat bad for Ramadan, because some people in my field, like a lot of other bodybuilders in my field, they're like, you know, that time of Ramadan, come on, like Imran, I can't eat six times anyway. What we gonna do? I said, well, here what we gonna do, right? We're using protein to sustain you and to maintain your muscle mass for the period of Ramadan. Then rather going to eat poorly throughout Ramadan. But remember, these things can make pancakes, these things can make waffles, these things can make put in your oats, these things can help you to get more drive when you're tired. These things have diuretics. If your body holding subcutaneous water, can get you to pee more. These things can help regulate your bowel function, so you go to the toilet more. All these things. So it's basically, and then it like, you don't get tired. So let me give you an example. When you drink one cup of coffee, right? One cup of coffee is equivalent to 150 milligrams of caffeine. You can drink 2 cups, 3 cups, 4 cups until your body becomes tolerant to the stimulant called caffeine androgens. Now the thing about it is that with these supplements, we have something that supports your adrenal gland. So the body never gets tolerant. So every time you take it, it's like the first time you're taking it. So it doesn't, it responds like the first time. Because once your adrenal gland basically gets tolerant and the receptor doesn't fire from using too much. Alright, remember we know everything in moderation. Too much of everything is not good. So therefore you're using the protein as a meal substitute in the morning when you wake up. After you finish cardio in the morning. So you get up in the morning, it's called fasted cardio. This is for all brothers and sisters who are looking to lose weight. Very easy. The trick in losing weight is that whatever you consume tonight at 8 o'clock will not digest till tomorrow, right? And you'll utilize carbohydrates. Carbohydrates, which is basically glycogen, breaks down into glucose and give the body energy, right? Your body now breaks down that glucose to give your body energy. Excess glucose is stored as what? Fat. And the source of energy that the body will use to live is what? Glycogen, sugar. So it makes no sense eating a banana or eating a meal and going to the gym if you're trying to lose weight. Because the body will try to break down that banana or that sandwich while you're doing cardio for an hour. So it don't make any sense. What would make sense? You do a 5 minutes warm up, a little ballistic stretch, or a little stretch, a little burpees, a little plyometric exercises. Go to the weight floor, bang out your weights, because they have more simple glycemic index triggers to drive it through a weight training program. And then you do your cardio at a low intensity steady state. Remember, we're burning calories, but we don't want to burn muscle. If you increase muscle mass, you'll burn fat faster. If you build muscle mass, you burn calories more efficiently. So, hence that, women don't have testosterone like men. So, we basically lose weight faster, right? But women now, they have to go through the whole supplementing, they have to watch your diet. It's a lot harder for them. Don't get me wrong, it's a lot harder than most women, and they have a lot more hormonal issues. Hormonal change with their body, menstrual cycle, the complications, that. So, you know, and stress is one of the major factors for women gaining weight. Stress, men and women, I'll tell you why. When you stress, you increase cortisol hormone. Cortisol hormone makes a woman or man feel very puffy and bloated in your rectus abdominis area, the core, right? So, we try to help you with stress. We try to tell people that stress should not be, the gym should be a stress reliever for you. You shouldn't go into the gym and stress. When you come to the gym, I'm here to de-stress you. What you want to do today, chest and biceps, push and pull, antagonistic training. So basically what we want to push here is like, okay, most brothers here, all brothers here have a big belly, right? Most of them, right? And what we have to understand, Indian people are mostly endomorphic structures and more susceptible to what? Hypertension, diabetes, right? We suffer from stress, but we have to try to control it and fix it. And exercise is the way to, I found that exercise is the way to fixing all those problems. So you get up in the morning, brother, you don't eat breakfast, you buy a treadmill from PriceMark, you go home, put it in your house, and you're convenient right after Fajr, get on the treadmill. Do your 1 hour cardio. After you finish that, your wife in the kitchen makes you protein shake for you. By the time you drink the protein shake, it's time to go on the road. Time to go down, your commute from, let's say, 11 Shogunas, you have to go to Shogunas to town now, to go, right? That commute is about an hour in the morning. You're drinking that protein shake as your breakfast. By the time you reach in work, a snack. We have plenty healthy substitute. We have protein bars. We have Greek yogurt. We have almond. We have granola. We have celery sticks and cottage cheese. We have so many things that you could use. Because remember, eating small portions of food more times through the day increases one's metabolic rate. So you have to actually eat smaller portions to increase the, to drive your metabolism, to help you to burn fat and to burn calories more efficiently. So starving or getting up in the morning, which most of us do, drink a cup of coffee and leave the house. Miss breakfast completely. And when lunchtime comes, what work boy, we go munch on something or you eat a sandwich, right? Or eat two doubles. And that's not a proper meal, right? And then after, the worst thing you can do is say this. Brother, I didn't have breakfast today, but I stopped for Julie Mango. Julie Mango has 15 grams of sugar, each mango. Each mango has 80 grams of carbs. So you tell me you just had 320 grams of carbs for breakfast and 60 grams of sugar. So it made more sense that you should have a bowl of oats, put a scoop of protein that has no sugar, and not even an artificial sweetener. That protein has stevia. Stevia comes from a plant. So it's not even like, all right, sugar is sugar. The body doesn't recognize sugar. Let me explain something. If you're drinking a Diet Coke, you're drinking a Coke, eating a Snickers bar, and you're in the bathroom eating honey, not because honey is better, it will be, the body will absorb it differently. We all eating sugar. The body cannot tell that you're drinking a Coke, eating Snickers, you're eating honey, eating agave, organic maple syrup, you're taking agave. Sugar is sugar. The body will do what? Spike insulin. The body will increase blood glucose levels. The only thing about honey, it will digest slowly. It might stay in the system a lot longer than granulated sugar. So that's hence the reason you might see somebody going to the gym and overtrain, and their blood sugar level drop and they become hypoglycemic. What do? You put a little dinner mint in the mouth. You give them an apple. You put a little Gatorade in the mouth. Why you put anything in the mouth? Because it's simple glycemic index sugar. But you ever realize most of our children and most of the people around society run on Gatorade? And 36 grams of sugar is Gatorade. Now, a lot of companies now are looking for sugar substitute, but it's just as bad. Sugar is sugar. Not because you're drinking a Diet Coke, and your Diet Coke says zero calories. Your Diet Coke sets up artificial sweeteners, which mimic sugar. So the body recognizes sugar and digests that sugar. All it does not do is get any calories. So at the end of the day, we're about checking calories. If you want to lose weight, you have to be in a calorie deficit. The supplements assist with weight loss because it repairs muscle tissue. Now we have type 1 and type 2 muscle fibers. Type 1 muscle fibers is for speed. That's what you run with. Type 2 muscle fibers is power lifters. That's the men who do power lifting. Right? So basically, it depends on what goal and what muscle you're trying to, what look you're trying to achieve. So if it's mostly cardiovascular fitness, we just have to focus on the cardio part of it. But too much cardio burns muscle mass. So bear in mind, let me explain for you, your fitness level and his fitness level will be completely different, right? So going on a treadmill and doing cardio, walking for a longer period of time is actually better for losing weight than running. We have a lot of factors that will happen when you start to run. When you run, you go into something called your anaerobic threshold. You know what is the anaerobic threshold? We have an aerobic threshold and anaerobic. Anaerobic threshold means we burn only protein synthesis. We burn our muscle. Hence the reason a 1500 meter sprinter and a 100 meter sprinter. Perfect example. A 100 meter sprinter trains for speed, for agility. A 1500 meter runs for cardiovascular fitness and endurance. So obviously he will be depleted. You understand where I'm coming from? So we don't want to do too much cardio and not feed the body the nutrients it needs, because then you're going to lose muscle mass. And don't do one of those crazy fat diets where you hear no carbs. Because this will affect you all. No carbs, you can't lose weight on no carbs. That might make you look skinny for a day or two. And if they start by eating, they blow up bones. They get bigger than how you was before. Because that is not dieting. Dieting is not... We don't live dieting. We live eating a healthy lifestyle. So, portion control, moderation, they're the healthier choice. What would you pick? White rice or brown rice? Brown rice. What would you eat? Quinoa? Quinoa or white rice? Quinoa, because you're eating greens. What is better, potato or sweet potato? Good. But there are other provisions that are also good. What? What? Basmati rice is fine, but it's what time of the day you're eating it. You see, alright, rice is a simple glycemic index sugar. So they always say if you have to eat rice, always eat it before you train. Or eat it lunchtime. Do not eat rice at night. Generally, because the body cannot break down carbohydrates at night. Even if it's basmati rice, even if it's brown rice, even if it's sweet potato, you try to not eat carbs at night. But you can have your carbs for breakfast, you can have your carbs for lunch. But try to minimize, remember, you are trying to lose weight. Now, it will be completely different for somebody, like my bodybuilder's friend over there, who wants to gain muscle mass. They would then eat the carbs at night, because they just finish a workout in the gym. And only if you finish a workout in the gym as a hard, rigorous, strenuous workout, then you can have a little bit of carbs into your diet to repair your glycogen levels. Alright, remember? So when you eat sugar, it repairs glycogen level, like tops it up there. Carbohydrates have to convert to glycogen, then glycogen has to convert to glucose. So at the end of the day, after training session, you take your protein shake, you drink your protein shake, make sure your protein shake has a little carb, so throw a little bit of oats in it, and drink that, and then it goes for body. But when you go home, after the gym, you have a salad. Okay, if you want to snatch your own hand, popcorn. Popcorn is healthy, Greek yogurts and prunes. You eat almonds, you eat, you can have like protein bars. You can even make your own protein or meat cookies at home using rye, spelt, flour, things that are organic. You know, because organic food digests faster. So, I mean, it's harder for the woman, easier for the man. Alright, but I mean, you have to supplement to help you to get through the program easily. You get branching amino acids are for what? BCAA is leucine, isoleucine, valine, glutamine, and hyca. These things help the muscle to repair muscle tissue. So when you train, you go through what? Catabolism. Catabolism is a breakdown of muscle tissue. So you lose muscle while training. So to repair muscle, you have to drink this stuff to keep the muscle basically intact, keep it looking the way it's looking. When you drink your protein shake, it's for recovery, and then protein shakes will also be used as a meal, depending on one's lifestyle, how busy they are. Now, at the same time, we don't want you to starve. So it's all based on calorie consumption and calorie expenditure. You cannot build muscle on a calorie deficit. Think about it logically. How could you get big? You're about how much? 150? 5'9"? Nice. So you're trying to get big, but your calorie consumption is about 1400, 1500 calories. Impossible. You will never grow. Now you might go if you might get pain, you might get a little pump, but you will never grow. So you need to up your calorie intake at least 500 more calories than what your body burns naturally. And how do you find out your basal metabolic rate? So you know, burns over average 2000 calories a day. You need to have at least 500,000 calories more than that. Could you eat 3,000 calories of food a day? Maybe not one box of KFC, you could, or 2 box, but that's not proper food. I'm talking about get up in the morning, a bowl of oats, 200 grams of oats, 6 boiled eggs. I'm not saying that's a choice. I mean,
I think we're looking for the competitive lifestyle. But you're doing this because you want to live a healthier lifestyle, but you want to put on some weight. But you can't eat the amount of food to get weight, that's the reason for the supplement. The supplement will give you the extra push. The creatine help boost ATP, adenosine triphosphate. The creatine help you increase water retention in your body. 95% of our skeletal part of our human body produces creatine. So by taking creatine, we're just increasing the performance, which needs water to sustain it. Because if you don't take the water in while drinking creatine, your body takes water from your organs. And the body is made up of what? 75% water. So we need to understand that everything boils down to science. You have us here, my team, who are very knowledgeable. I'll put Shimon on, you can ask him some questions. He's very knowledgeable on supplementing, training, everything, just like myself. Any questions you want to ask? Shiv? Anything about people who have thyroid problems, people pregnant, you cannot take supplements if you're pregnant. If you're breastfeeding, you cannot take supplements if you're breastfeeding. All these things you need to know, we have the answers for it, but we will guide you through it. And our number is available. Anybody want to call us to talk about it? Our phone is open 24/7. Body by Man. It's 4 stores nationwide, and we always open. We don't close. So even though the stores might close, but hear your questions and answers, all right? Anybody might want questions, like conflict with whatever complications on the woman's side, right, and on the men's. Or they ask some questions, huh? Whatever you want to know.
Where you get a quota from?
All right, so Iman bought this quota for me. Iman, where did you get this
quota? From in the next book. All right.
So the quota is open. Anybody want to answer?
And any question when it comes to like, alright, so yes, I live a competitive lifestyle. You might have the woman who just want to live a healthy lifestyle. The man, I don't want to go on no stage, I don't want porn, I'm not going up anywhere to do no fashion show. I just want to do this for me. I want to be healthy, I want to be fit, I don't like all this fat here, I don't like all this rough handles, I want to get rid of that. My clothes fit in my tight, I'm not feeling good about myself, my cholesterol level high. What could I do? What can help me fix that by just training? Or what supplement should I take to assist me with that? Now, as I say, woman, if you're on any metformin or glucophage medication for PCOS, or the doctor will put you on birth control or something for it, these things can be fixed through exercise.
I've
done it multiple times. The next time I'm doing this, my live feed on Facebook will be testimonies about all the women who were 250, 300, who lost 100 pounds and not able to conceive. And who are able now to get the menstrual cycle regular, because when you have PCOS, you lose all of that. Alright? So, anything you want to ask these for us, you know? So brothers?
You can take supplements without working out too. Well, carotene.
Stop putting my clothes on.
Alright, so like I said, your diet is lacking in something, whether it's protein, carbs, minerals. If you are lacking, then yes, you can supplement with it. It is not necessary to do the physical activity, however, the physical activity will help greatly. In anything you want to do. Sorry. Alright. Does that answer your question? Anyone else? Anything?
Anything, I mean, pertaining to these supplements, anything?
How
is it to make your water carry the water protein? Alright, so the protein per day varies greatly with everyone. Now, the first thing I'd have to ask you is, what's your goal? You're trying to put on weight, drop weight, stay the same weight? What is your goal? What are you trying to do? Alright, so daily recommended value of protein, right? They actually say it's proven that it should be around 0.9 to 1.5 grams per pound, which is very high. Right? But majority of people don't get that to begin with. Now when you don't get that, what happens is you feel a little more lethargic, you look a little softer, your body breaks down a little more, you actually hold on to more fat when you don't have enough protein. And protein isn't just needed for making muscle, it is needed to make hair, skin, nails, hormones. Basically, a lot of the processes that the body undergoes, it needs protein. Right? So when you're deficient in that, the body simply doesn't function the way it's supposed to. It doesn't function optimally. Now, the protein can come from animal source, plant source, a mixture. It doesn't matter as long as you make the right amount of protein. Right? It's the same with carbs. When you don't get enough carbs or when you don't get enough fat, your body doesn't function the way it's supposed to.
What is the... Is it better
taken
before workout or after workout for muscle repair?
Right, now for muscle repair, old school style, they would tell you to take a scoop of protein before and a scoop after. However, with the modern times now, what we see, they have greater amount of proteins in the actual amino acids, so that doesn't need to push digestion. So if I give you a score protein before you go to train, and you go to train, chances are you throw it out if you have a heavy weight system. Right? So what you need to do is really BCA, branched chain amino acids. So what we have there is anabolic state, that is plant-based. That is the amino acids from plants, so it's a vegan, because plant-based, so it's vegan, and it's halal as well. So you can use that while you're training. So that's a broken down digested form of protein while you're training. Or you can have it before as well too. And right after you finish training, then you use the protein. And because you're not training, protein will it will make you upset anymore because you're not training.
After a morning workout,
yeah.
You sometimes feel a little burnt out for the rest of the day. Mm-hmm. So that would help in
definitely. What my personal recommendation, take one scoop of the creatine micronized, mix it with a scoop of the anabolic state, and drink it as a post-workout recovery when you finish training. Before you train, you take the Supernova, which is a vasodilator. Now, caffeine is a blood restrictor, not a vasodilator. So you drink Supernova as a pre-enhancer to make you go in the gym and train harder. And it has things like augmentin sulfate, citrulline malate, beta-alanine, all these things help you to increase vasodilation, get better pumps while you're training, push a little harder while you're training. And think about it, at the end of it, you just recover yourself with a branching amino acid and a creatine. The creatine is just to put back in the natural, the glycogen level that you have burned out, help with your strength, help with energy, help with recovery. But again, these are just everyday supplements. There's nothing there that could be detrimental to you, nothing that could kill you, nothing could have an effect on your kidneys, nothing have an effect on your bladder, could nothing have an effect on your liver. Because at the end of the day, yes, your liver does most work in the body, but you're not abusing the supplements. Understand? Again, I go back to moderation is the key. Little, more times a day, when it comes to the supplement, not because you take two tablets twice a day and they lose 20 pounds, you're going to start to take three tablets because they want to lose 10 more pounds. That means you just have to work harder to lose 10 more pounds. And that's where it becomes an addiction. That's where it becomes an addiction because you get so dependable on these supplements now that you have to literally, remember, supplements are not magic. That is just a supplement. It's just to help you to recover, to aid, to help, and to prevent you from breaking down. It's not going to make you look like me. If you understand, it's not going to make you thin to six-pack, big chest, big arms, you know? You're not going to get that. But with hard work, eating properly, food should always be a base. But we don't have the knowledge of what the right food to eat. We quick to eat bread and cheese. Bread will only last 30 minutes in your system. That's not good food. Right? And at the end of the day, you want to eat, okay, so we have our rice, we have our spinach, baji, we have our chicken breast. You have for your snacks, your popcorn, as I say, healthy snacks. Your lunch, dinner time come, you want to have whole grain pasta, gluten-free pasta. Only 1% of this world has celiac disease. So none of you all here have intolerance to gluten. Gluten is a wheat, it's a protein. People just love in this industry now, we don't want any gluten, we don't want gluten, we don't want gluten, and you basically push that on you. You know? You start to tell when you go out to the grocery, oh, I want gluten-free stuff. You don't have a celiac disease problem. Gluten-free means that a person cannot digest wheat in the GI tract. The intestinal tract cannot absorb the gluten, so they get diarrhea. And I don't think anybody here has that problem when they eat oats.
What about the age? For
instance,
like if they have children, what is the recommended age
limit? Well, it depends on how your child is. Is he or she obese? Are they overweight? Well, yeah, there's no. Well, from my age, I started at 15. I'm 35 now. But at the end of the day, I've been doing this for the past 20 years, personal training for the past 18 years. So at the end of the day, I will say for children, I won't give them supplements. I will start them with the base food. Train hard, eat properly, like how I did it. I didn't know about supplements when I was 15. I started when I was 16 though, because I was in Salai Gym, Digger Martin, and then obviously you don't know better, so you were talking with the trainers and they were telling you, you know, you should try this. So I would say give your son or your daughter, however age is, let them start with the basics before you get them into any supplement, and actually could take a supplement that I can't take.
and asked him, so how long, brother, are you taking supplements? He said, well, I take a supplement for about 2 years now. So he started when he was 15 using pre-workouts. His tolerance is so how to say, high to caffeine, that basically, if I take that, I will pass out. I will freak out. My body will start to get antsy. I will feel like pins and needles sticking all over my skin. Beta-alanine does that. It uses as a lactic acid buffer. So I would say to your son, daughter, let them start very low, beginners. Give them proper food to eat. If they want snacks, okay, they are also healthy snacks. If they want bad food, okay, one hot dog won't get them fat. But I'm saying, don't make hot dog and pizza and KFC and Royal Castle their base food. Start to cook from home. Eggs, chicken breast, fish. Put baby carrots and hummus. Give them, they will eat it. Put the vegetables, they'll eat it. But you see, if you go, it's like me, I don't eat roti. Every Eid's pass, I don't eat roti. So how come I eat Muslim? Big Eid celebration, home and I eat pass roti straight. I will go by friends who will have bread and pass it straight. I don't eat flour. But I don't have celiac disease. I just don't like how flour reacts to my body. So everybody's body is different. That guy there might say he flour doesn't melt. This lady here might say I like brown rice rather than white rice. You hear people cons and pros, and at the end of the day, you just have to work around it because we are here to advise them. So you know, a typical Indian, big belly Indian, dal belly Indian, whatever you want to call it, getting up every morning, salad roti and baigan choker, salad roti and takari, salad roti and fraru, salad roti and butter. Doubles, pie, come on, it's like you have to change that lifestyle because they realize. I don't know if I realize yet, but...
The truth.
The culture we grew up in, it messed another. By the time 15, 16, you are high cholesterol. Yeah. I did a full blood analysis test and posted up on social media the other day. I did something like that. I ate bad food for a month. I did this just to prove to the world. I ate KFC, Royal Castle, pizza, doubles. I lived like a normal human being, like how you will live for a month. My cholesterol went up to 255. I'm only 35. Borderline high, I was at 8 risk. My HDL went down and I had good cholesterol. Right. I went on Omega XL. I started supplementing, started taking a fat burner, cut out all my simple glycemic index sugars, cut out all fats from food, stop eating outside food, cook home. My cholesterol is now 140. One month. And I post that all over internet, social media platforms just to show people. Oh, your liver enzyme. My liver enzyme would have changed too, depending on what supplement you're using, because the liver will respond to different activities. Your crealkaline levels would have gone up because you're training harder. But my cholesterol is perfect now, and I'm the doctor. But now I'm trying to say, all you have to do, when it comes to eating, we have so many healthier choices in life. It takes 5 slices of bread to make 1 bagel, and you'll eat bagel and cream cheese. Imagine that. It takes 7 cricks to make 1 slice of bread. But you're eating 5 slices of bread for breakfast. I'm just saying. I'm saying you're doing it personally. Yes, if you desire to have a cheat meal or a cheat snack. Say you have been in the gym for 3 weeks and you're like, Imran, I'm feeling deprived. I'm feeling for a craving. I feel for something sweet. What do I do? I say, hey, what to do? What are you feeling for? I say, go and have it. Satisfy your craving. That's the next point I was coming to. Because understand, you're dieting. You can't live dieting. You'll get sick. Understand that? So you train hard, eat properly, and when you feel fit, have it and get it back out of the system. But don't keep it in your house. Get rid of it. Get it and eat it or give some neighbor it or friend it. Don't keep it because every day you'll open that fridge, you'll see the cheesecake, you'll take a piece. Tomorrow, God, that day, boy, still, let me take the next piece. Next day, you eat it again until you eat the whole cake. You eat the whole cake for yourself. I'm saying, if you want to live a healthier lifestyle, you need to do things to, you know, plan it. Right, that's what Ramadan coming in April, right? We're going to start to fast. And mentally, the night before, you have to prepare yourself. That is the same thing what prepping meals are and bodybuilding is for. We have to get up Sunday night and cook 20 chicken breasts, 20 tilapia, a bowl of broccoli, a bowl of pigeon peas, 2 cup of brown rice, sweet potato, package all that in the fridge. And when we get up in the morning, we have about 6 containers below. And we just pack the food and all that, microwave and go. And that's how we eat. But every Friday, Saturday, or Saturday, once for the week, you allow one bad meal, just to help with this, your mindset. Because you start to get aggressive, you start to get headaches, you start to feel deprived. Yeah. So you know what I'm talking about. So I go. So at the end of the day, what we want to advise you on, any product you take over there, we can give you any advice on it, what it will do for you, what to expect from it. The good thing about it, it's halal, so you don't have to worry with what you're taking is, you know, not halal and not good for your body. No, it's not vegetable protein. It's a vegetarian protein. It has no egg, but it's not vegan. Because I don't want soy in men. I don't want men drinking soy protein. That's bad. I do not want men to increase the estrogen. That's bad. You want to elaborate a little more on it? Why?
Alright, well, soy raises estrogen, right? Estrogen is a female sex hormone. Men have both male and female, right? Now, when you throw the estrogen off, that increases risk for high blood pressure, cholesterol, all these other things. And there's a bunch of, along with the complication that comes.
Now, like men should do so.
Exactly, it throws off your hormones, your balance, right? And it's vice versa with women, right? So the processed food actually does that to women and men as well. The processed food can lower the testosterone as well. Right, now the protein we have there, it is milk, right? Milk as in whey protein, it comes from milk. Now, however, that is filtered to the point where it doesn't have any lactose, it doesn't have any gluten, it's sugar free. So it's very, very protein, right? 28 grams of protein, 1 to 2 calories, and it's halal as well. Now the amino acids we have are plant-based,
So that's
where you get the amino acids from, plants.
And the world is going plant, and the world, if you watch all this, you know, most people are going plant-based stuff. Why? It's more natural. So we want to push the natural on you. Alright?
So we only have about 10 minutes again for the Alandri call, inshallah. If anybody have any questions,
anything, fellas, or they want to join gym, or they're doing what they're wrong in gym?
We have a gym upstairs, as a reminder, we have a gym upstairs.
That we will be putting?
And we will, inshallah, put the training every
I think it makes a vibe. I think with the gym upstairs, being in the mosque there, I don't know if the mosque will be putting someone there to overlook or oversee who will be doing what. But I'll tell you something, I will be doing programs and sticking it up on the wall so that you could come into the gym and say, okay, today we have chest and triceps or back and biceps, or chest and triceps or quads with shoulders and hamstring with calves. So at least you have an idea of what to do, because you can just read and understand how much sets, how much reps. And then we could also put some healthy eating lifestyle plans so that you could get an idea of how to start living a healthy lifestyle. You're never too late to know. You're never too late. I just had a woman, she was 380 pounds. How much is today? Michelle. 380, she's 240 in 7 months. And this person life changed. So for people who want to gain weight, it's not hard. If you want to lose weight, it's going to come with time. It's not going to happen overnight. But you will see it. Under good hands and under good advice and under good instructions and listening to us, you will see it.
Is there vegan protein with all the soy?
Yes, we have that, but it's one of nutrition is made from peas, like peas, like organic pumpkin seeds, hemp seeds, yes. And have no soy in it.
Okay.
And it's also gluten-free, and it also no sugar, and only has 3 grams of carbohydrates, 25 grams of protein, but it doesn't taste all that good. Remember, protein, vegan protein does not taste good, because you're asking for a plant-based product to taste really good. Plant-based vegetable products that we have there in this product line taste good, because fruit, the milky ones, doesn't taste good.
So I have 2 questions.
Yeah,
first, what would you say are somebody things we could do to speed up the metabolism?
Okay.
And the second question is the creatine. When you take the creatine, how long after this year the water weight go?
All right. So creatine, because 95% of the skeletal part of the human body produces it, right? When you take creatine, it's recommended that you have 10 grams a day, but don't have it at one single serving. The body will excrete the rest. So you take 5 grams in the morning on an empty stomach and 5 grams post-workout recovery or pre-training. Now, after you finish your bottle of creatine, but what creatine drives on is water, in about 4 days after that subcutaneous water comes up, so your body cannot sustain it. And the more cardio you do, you'll get rid of the water too, faster.
so it wouldn't stay. And if you want to get rid of it, because you don't like that bloated, puffy look you're getting, you could just go with drinking green tea, about 3 cups a day, 500 milligrams.
How could I spike
a slow metabolism, start doing heavyweight training, and start doing cross training, like berries, or like a lot of supersets, giant sets, start doing plyometrics in between your workouts, so do a lot of active rest training, start, keep your heart rate elevated. So basically, like, you're doing chest, let me give you an example, flat chest press, you know what a flat chest press is, incline dumbbell chest press, flat dumbbell flies, but it's dropping right there, all three is a superset, a giant set, drop and do burpees with push-ups. Now that now sends your heart rate up, elevates the heart rate, but you get faster recovery because why? You are increasing oxygen. So you get a faster recovery because there's training like that. Now remember, you're not going on any stage in it to compete. So you're just doing this to live healthy and look ripped and look lean and look chiseled. So you need to up your calorie expenditure, also look at what calories you're consuming. But I believe volume training, Tabata training, cross training will help chisel your body out with a proper nutrition plan and proper supplementing. If you want to check us more on the supplementing side, we can advise you on that.
What is the shelf life of
the products? 2 to 3 years. So 2022, those things will expire. After any time, you might finish about 5 bars before that, or 6. It's literally, I believe in supplementing. I've been supplementing since I was 17. My first supplement was Phosphagen HP. I don't know if you ever know a brand, Metrex 1000. And Universal. It's still out there. But it's not as, and designed away. It's not as big as these products. These are the new products, but we have had this brand in our store for 7 years. But they have now become a halal supplement company because they choose to go into the Middle East and sell. So it was a game changer for us because we already were carrying the product for 7 years. So they were like, hey, what? I think we have a huge Muslim clientele in Trinidad. So they were like, yeah, no problem, we'll sell it. So those products, I think once you get into the products, we can advise you more on it. And my phone is open to anyone who wants advice daily about it, how to take it, what to take, what not to eat, what to eat. We're open for that. All right? And you can follow us on Instagram and social media platforms, Body by Man. We have 4 stores nationwide. We're also in MS Food City in Davie. But I know most of you are from around this area. All right, so that's it. Any questions, ladies? We have different goals. So you might have a goal as an aspiring bodybuilder, right there. You might want to gain some weight. You might want to lean up. But it's your personal preference, your personal choice. We just want to make it more understandable for people that it's possible regardless what ethnicity you are, regardless if you're Indian or not, if it was African, if it was, a different body structure, it wouldn't make a difference. Hard work, training will pay off. What you're trying to achieve, you just need the proper guidance. And that's what we're here for, to help you, to guide you. Give me a typical routine that you go to the gym and train with. Let me hear one of your routines, and I'll tell you what are my routine. What do you call a chest day? Let me hear a chest day for me. Your reps, your sets, and your time in the gym.
Every Monday is world chest day, you know that.
But we know that, I see. So tell me your chest routine, I'll tell you mine.
Flat and flying flies.
So from here?
Flat bench.
Right. How many sets and how many reps?
12-10-8.
Pyramid, but why start from 12-10-8? Why just start 20-15, 12-10-8-6 and then drop set?
Like our custom trainers.
Right, I want to show you how you can maximize on ripping and tearing more muscle fibers. I'm a bodybuilder, don't train with type 1 or type 2. You train with all muscle fibers. And what you're trying to achieve is to get lean. So you need to activate all those two. Remember, when you lift heavy weights, you're increasing testosterone. You're using type 2 muscle fibers and you're building muscle mass. But what I'm telling you, if every time you're pyramid and you're going up with the weight, right? And you're dropping the reps. Why when you reach your heaviest weight, you didn't do a drop set of the 4 reps for 50 reps? Right, they'll be burned out, but that's fine because we are ripping and tearing muscle. Okay, volume training means more weights, more sets, and more reps. So instead of doing incline press, do incline press, dumbbell, 5 sets of 8, superset it with 5 sets of 8 flies, and giant set it with a 45 plate between your legs doing dips. Now if you can't handle the weight, use a way that you can handle, but don't change the volume of your workout. Don't go into the gym and say 2 hours to do chest. Go into the gym and do 45 minutes chest. That is a good workout. Because you're depleting glycogen level faster. Now if you want to grow and you want to get bigger legs, obviously you need to spend more time. You need to focus on the squeeze and the contraction, eccentric, concentric part, and you need to build muscle and variation. So when you go to do your chest next day, do this routine for me. Do flat barbell chest press for 10 reps. Do incline barbell chest press for 10 reps. Do decline barbell chest press for 10 reps. And then drop on the ground and put a 45 plate on your back and do push-ups for 10 reps. Now do that 5 times with a 1 minute rest. But try your weight, not my weight. I'm going to do it with 245. You try with your weight. Try when you're doing that next routine now. After that, you have pullovers and you have cable crossovers. But those reps will be 20 and 30. Huh? Oh, you're training this gym up here? Okay, so again. Yeah, they need to get a cable machine. See, again, it's like I was talking to them on my Instagram, like we could try to raise funds to make the gym a better place, to get more equipment. I think if only brothers come together and what we do, like what? Do something to have raise funds to buy equipment. That hard. Who's that? Okay, we'll talk to him.
Financer.